Hi guys, today I will show you two rare cameras I just received from eBay. So, first one is a Minolta Maxxum 9XI. So it was a high grade, professional grade camera from Minolta with a metal case and one of the fastest shutter ever. It was at 1/12,000th of a second, guys. So it is quite incredible. I got it for 9 euros because it is in quite rough shape, but it is seems to be working at least. The base plate here is in die cast, you can see, and this thing makes an awesome noise. This and this. It is just awesome, so I will show you the shutter speed you can have. I'm sure anyway more how to get this. Maybe in the viewfinder, yes, here. So, 1/4,000th of a second, 12,000th of a second, guys. It is just incredible. When you see the shutter working at this speed, in fact, you see nothing. It is really, really good. It makes an awesome noise. Very, very sturdy camera. With lots of features, have a LCD screen in the viewfinder, overlaying info in the picture you see. So this is a quite junky, crappy lens, but you can see the very nice body in here. It is very, very fast also. Just incredible. So I am quite happy with it. There is then a backlight of LCD here. Some eye detection here. Picture. And very, very good metering system as far as I know. So I am quite happy with this thing. Nice addition for my collection because it is not a usual one you can get easily. Quite a rare one. Okay, then second one, sadly this one is not working at all. It is a very rare ASO Ricoh Mirai camera. It is a single lens reflex with all-in-one design, you can see. It was quite a marketing failure because it was not so great for ergonomics. The weight is not evenly distributed, it is too heavy here. It was with 4 AAA batteries. It has a quite good zoom inside, very nice. And a flipping flash unit here. Quite noisy when you release it. But it releases very fast. So there is a good autofocus system in it. It was quite good, good working camera, but bad ergonomics and very expensive as far as I know. So it was not a marketing system. You can see the shutter is just like a regular reflex camera shutter. So this on grip here was not too bad, in fact. So there is a LCD display here, very weird location for a LCD display. Not convenient at all, because when you have your eye here, you want to check the info, you have to go see the info here. But there is also some info displayed in the viewfinder. This is the light frame for the viewfinder LCD. Okay, and you can see lots of rubber parts which are not sticking well. I have two of these cameras. The other one is in less good condition. This one externally is good. I'm just missing a cover here for the hot shoe. You can see the very, very special hot shoe. Not convenient at all because it was a proprietary design. I got it for 5 euros, so I do not complain. There is the original landscape, what was good to have. It was quite a weird camera this time. There were several kind of several cameras of this kind released, I believe, in the beginning of the 90s, and it did not it was not a marketing success. Okay, so these are my two latest add-ons to my camera collection. I am still checking eBay for more. Maybe soon I hope an Olympus digital reflex. There is one sold for parts on eBay. Now I will try to get it. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.